Now the contents basically consist of introduction, what is contouring, finishing and polishing. These definitions are very important. The desirable characteristics of an abrasive, the design of an abrasive instrument, the abrasive action, then the factors affecting the rate of abrasion, the factors influencing the efficiency of the abrasives, the types of abrasives, that is the classification. In here there are basically two types of classifications, the types of polishing agents, and finally air abrasion technology. Now another very upcoming technology known as air abrasion technology is also a method of polishing or finishing various restorations. So it uses an instrument which works as like a mini sandblaster. So I'm sure you're all aware of sandblasting. So this aims a very thin stream of aluminium oxide particles, and these particles are basically in nanometers, at the decayed parts of the teeth. And compressed air propels these particles towards the tooth surface, and this action sprays away the decay from the surface of the teeth when it is, which is then sucked out. So the higher speed stream of these aluminium oxide particles causes an abrasive action on the tooth surface, specifically towards the decayed or the carious part, and it basically propels them towards the tooth surface and sprays away the decayed part. The instrument doesn't create any heat, any sound, pressure or vibration, and that is why it is popular. However, this is expensive, so you will not be seeing too much of this procedure, and it's definitely, it has its own advantages compared to the conventional method of drilling or tooth cutting. Advantages of air abrasion over the traditional drill: reduced need of anesthesia, especially when the tooth cavity is shallow, because it's, like I mentioned, it's not invasive, it's very it's not destructive, it's very conservative. Leaves more of the healthy tooth tissue behind because you are just aiming or targeting for the decayed part. Leaves the working area relatively dry, which is helpful when placing composite fillings. You must be aware, when we are doing the conventional drilling with our handpiece, it has water spray in it. So, and that is necessary because it generates a lot of heat. So that is, with that, it is difficult to maintain a dry field. And as you know, moisture control or isolation is essential for majority of our dental procedures. So in that case, especially for when we are doing composite fillings, we need a dry field, we need isolation, and in that case air abrasion technology is very beneficial because there is no need of water. Reduced risk of microfracturing and chipping of the tooth, which some believe can lead to premature restorative failures with the dental drill, as it's invasive and it's basically works at high speed and generates a lot of heat, sound and vibration. There can be fracture, the tooth can fracture if you're not careful enough. So, but with this technology, there is reduced risk of those kind of accidents happening. This allows the dentist to treat multiple sites in the mouth during a single visit. With the conventional dental drill, the limitation is that we cannot treat more than one or two teeth, because obviously it creates pain, heat, vibration, it's uncomfortable for the patient. But with this technology, we can do multiple sites in a single visit. The procedure is relatively simple and quick, so that basically if the patient is happy and the patient is comfortable. So basically this is what air abrasion technology is, and right now we'll just be doing the basics of it. If you have any more questions, please do ask me. Thank you so much for your time.